Hi guys, Mike here, and this is a video comparison between the ASUS Transformer Prime and the ASUS Transformer Infinity, both Android slates available on the market right now. And we're going to start with the exterior for both of these tablets, and you'll notice that both actually come with aluminum cases. We have the amethyst gray version of the Prime here and the champagne gold versus of the Infinity. Both are available in these two color options, and both come with metallic backs with circular pattern, as you can see here. Looks good, both feel very solid. However, there is one difference on the Infinity. You have a plastic strap here on top, and that's because beneath this strap there is in fact the antennas for the wireless and GPS signals signal. As you probably know, the ASUS Transformer Prime actually had problems with those, and ASUS went with this approach in order to actually solve the problems. Putting the two tablets side by side, you're going to notice that they're exactly the same in terms of weight, in terms of size as well, and they're pretty much the same in terms of thickness. There's one difference though. On the ASUS Transformer Prime, the edges were sharper than on the ASUS Transformer Infinity, which actually makes the Infinity a bit more comfortable to hold with both your hands. And in terms of ports, they also bring the same features, but they're differently placed. For the ASUS Transformer Prime, you had a speaker here, you also have a speaker on the Infinity, but on this side you had the headset jack over here, while on the Infinity you only have a small microphone jack. On top, on the Infinity you have the volume rocker and you also have the power button, while on this one you only had a microphone and the power button. And on this other side you had the volume rocker here, on the Prime, the micro HDMI port, the micro SD card port, and a microphone, while on the Transformer Infinity you have only the micro HD micro SD card reader here, a microphone, the micro HDMI, and the headset jack here on the bottom. While on this lower part, both of these devices come with proprietary docking connectors, also used for charging, and of course these latches that will help you attach the two to their docking stations. Both these tablets actually feature docking stations, and they're actually identical. The docking station that was designed for the Transformer Prime earlier this year will also work on the Transformer Infinity. So if you already have one, you don't have to buy one for the Infinity as well. You have here the both options, this one on amethyst gray and this one on champagne gold. They're basically the same. On both of these you have a keyboard, and it feels quite comfortable. You can use it to input content on your tablet. The keyboards also have dedicated buttons that you're going to use in Android. The arrow keys are slightly smaller, and you also have a trackpad. A bit stiff here, but overall alright, it will do the job. Inside you also have a battery, and attaching the actual tablets to this docking station is fairly easy. In order to remove them, you just have to press the latch towards the left and just remove the tablet like this, and in order to attach it you have to center the arrow here on the tablet with the arrow on the docking station, press it, and that's it. It's now attached, and while attached the docking station, the battery inside the docking station will actually charge the battery inside of the tablet. And speaking of the docking station, it also comes with a couple of ports, and I'm going to show them to you over here. You have this, the proprietary charging dock. You also have a full-size USB port over here, and a full-size SD card reader as well. And when combined, these devices will actually look like a laptop. They feel very solid, and they will provide good performances and up to 15 hours of battery life, which is of course not bad at all for a device that only weighs about 1 kilo, one and a bit kilo. Both these tablets actually feature excellent displays, 10.1 inch in diagonal. However, they have different resolutions. You have standard HD ready 1280 by 800 pixels on the ASUS Transformer Prime, and you have full HD 1920 by 1200 pixels resolution on this one, on the ASUS Transformer Infinity. Right now you don't really have the apps to show the differences between the two, but especially when it comes to text, you're going to actually feel a difference here. And let me zoom in a little bit so you will be able to see that for yourself. Check out this very nice looking widget here. You're going to notice that some of the icons here aren't looking as good because they're not optimized for the high resolution screen. And in comparison, the widget on this Transformer Prime is not looking as crisp, and the icons are just the same. I should also mention that the ASUS Transformer Infinity is built on a slightly faster Tegra 3 platform, running at 1.7 GHz for a single core, and when multiple cores are running, this is clocked at 1.6 GHz, while this is clocked at 1.4 and 1.3 GHz for multiple cores running. So overall, this should be snappier despite the fact that this processor has to push more pixels, about 50% more pixels on the screen of this particular tablet. Both of them will offer pretty much the same apps because ASUS doesn't change a lot the default Android iteration. Of course, you have all the Google applications and they're running very good and are excellently built for Android 4.0. You have these ASUS bundled applications like MyNet, okay, MyNet, MyCloud, and MyLibrary, and of course you have Polaris Office that you can use in order to edit documents, and these are all included for free. You can go ahead and edit documents on both of these devices. You also have Tegra Zone, NVIDIA's Tegra Zone, where you can find content, games and stuff like this. And I'd say that both of these devices can run all the titles here without a problem. However, later down the road, you will be able to get games optimized for the full HD display of the ASUS Infinity, and they will actually look better than the games, the THD games available right now that are optimized for the 1280 by 800 pixel screen on the ASUS Transformer Prime and some of the other similar devices. So, in times, you will have a better gaming experience on the Transformer Infinity, but for now, these are pretty much on par. Also, both of them can manage, can actually run without a problem all kinds of video content, which is actually quite good. And if you're looking for more applications, you should go into the Play Store. Unfortunately, I haven't actually signed in on the Prime, on this particular Prime. And you can go on the App Store, get all the applications. Of course, the App Store is a little bit of a mess because you can't really say which application is meant for the big screen of the tablet. And of course, there are very, very few, if not any, applications meant for the full HD display on the Infinity, at least for now. But if you're watching this clip later, in a couple of months, there will probably be some good applications over there as well. You're probably aware that the ASUS Transformer Prime had some problems with wireless and GPS signal, and you should be happy to know that those were actually solved on the ASUS Transformer Infinity. You no longer have the wireless signal drop when you're going further away from your router to, like, I don't know, 50 plus feet with multiple obstacles between them. And that's actually quite good. I would say the performances are even a little bit better than what you get on the iPad or the ASUS Transformer TF300, which, once again, it's something you'll enjoy. And in terms of GPS, this can catch, while this had problems catching GPS signal while inside or even while in your car, this will catch the GPS signal very fast in probably less than 30 seconds in most of the tests I've performed. In the end, we should talk about two more things: battery life and performances. Both of these tablets feature a 25 watt hour battery, so same capacity. However, the Transformer Prime actually lasts longer, and that was actually expected because it has a lower resolution screen that will need less energy and a slightly slower platform with slower memory as well. Both of these will go for about 7 to 8 hours of life in average daily use, as long as you're selecting the balance mode. But the Prime can actually push about 1 to 1.5 hours longer, to up to 8.5, maybe 9 hours, which is actually quite good. While playing movies, 70 while looping 70 to 70 720p content, sorry, you will be able to get more than 10 hours on the Prime and about 9 hours on the ASUS Transformer Infinity, up to 10 hours if you're going on the on this other mode, on this echo mode, that actually affects a little bit the quality of the screen. And what's actually more important is that in games, while this one could last for about 6 hours, this one will only last for about four and a half hours. And that was once again expected because the platform is powerful and has to push more pixels towards this high resolution display. Still, only about 4 or 5 hours for gaming, that's not really that good, and I was hoping for more. As for the prices, ASUS pushes both of these devices right now for $499 for the 32 GB version. Wi-Fi only, of course, because the 4G LTE options will only be available later this year. So $499 for 32 GB of storage and $599 for 64 GB of storage. And this makes the both of these transformers about $100 cheaper than the equivalent iPads. However, there's no 16 GB version of this, which makes them and the iPad start at the same number, $500. Alright, this pretty much wraps up our video comparison between the ASUS Transformer Prime and the Infinity, and I'm actually glad to tell that ASUS managed to fix most of the issues I had with the ASUS Transformer Prime on their new tablet. All these while actually bringing a couple of improvements like a faster hardware and a very good screen with full HD resolution. Of course, both of these devices are starting at $499, and the Transformer Prime still has one thing on its side, and that's battery life, because it doesn't have the faster processor and it only has the standard HD ready screen. It will last for longer, for about 1 to 2, maybe 3 hours longer, based on what you're doing. But besides that, there's actually no reason why you shouldn't get the Transformer Infinity, especially that the docking station for the Prime actually works with the new version. Those are pretty much all the things I wanted to tell about these two tablets right now. The Transformer Infinity is for sure one of the best Android tablets available in stores, probably my favorite. If you want more details about it, you should see the complete video review and also our other comparisons with some of the other popular tablets available on the market, like the cheaper ASUS Transformer TF300 and both the Apple iPad 2 and the latest generation Apple iPad 3. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you like what we're doing here.